Dan's not being quiet over any of this, but he has certainly toned the threats down, meaning he knows that his threats are not working, that his threats are just idle, and I know it. The bit about calling 911 yesterday, he never made the call. There's nothing to it. There's nothing you can do to me standing out in the public street. And it's just things like that. And this is what happens when you push people to having no options at all. The legal system, you know, just a massive red tape and expense, and you can do what you're doing to me, but I don't know. A lot of mixed emotions, but I'm standing by what I've decided to do, the lengths I've had to do to come down here and deal with this clown. And in the end, whether I get him or not, I think it just shows your true colors, who you are, and the type of person you are. Me and Dan ain't that much separated in age, and his wife and my wife are not that much separated in age, so he's playing off the old crippled elderly guy thing being threatened by a trained killer. Good luck with that. Either way, we are packing up, and I'm taking Dianne to Miami. I put her through hell. I promised her a nice vacation down there where she can look around and see the sights, and she's never been. And we have another phony down there too, so I've got ulterior motives. Drive around and try to catch up with him. But I'll give it hell here one more day. I just won't sit out there. Very early in the morning here in Fort Myers, Florida, as we roll into the second day of the Dan Bernath series. I don't have the heart to wake up Dianne. We had an extremely long day yesterday and then came back here early. And it just never stopped. The videos, answering emails. I'm already just one day, and I am just so far behind on emails when I turn my back on this and the verifications, and they're very important to people. I'm going to let her sleep for a while because I feel like shit at some of the things that I ask her to do, that I drag her all over the place, you know. And Dianne doesn't like being tired any more than anyone else does, and it bothers me looking at her when she's dragging ass like that. And I'll try to let her sleep a little bit, and we're going to pack this place up, and we're going to go over and give Dan hell one more time. I spoke to a reporter last night who went over and knocked on Dan's door. I've got some reports on this. And knocked on Dan's door, and no one answered, of course. He probably thinks it was me. But he might accompany us tomorrow, or today. And I am going to, and I hate to do it, I avoided it yesterday. I spoke to law enforcement. They said, you know, we'll send the sheriff out there, you know, for you. And I was like, God damn it. You know, that's what those guys do. That's what the guys do that cry wolf and call the police over these frivolous, just depleting resources and taxpayers' money over bullshit. The other guys do that. However, today, I think it'll be entertaining for an officer in a break in the monotony, but I plan on having one of those guys show up and escorting me up on Dan's porch. And we're going to give it hell. We're going to give it every opportunity to work today.
It's day two of the Dan Bernath saga. We had a very late night last night, taking care of everything that gets neglected after a single day of going after these phonies. A very early morning this morning. We're both really tired and we're both really agitated. And we're going back over here today to talk to that clown. So this is about enough to test a marriage, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm pretty spun up here this morning. And I just want to get down there and get this thing done. So whether he comes out or not, which would be nice, but it speaks volumes about you when you won't show yourself or you just run away. And that's what he's done, big and tough in front of a computer screen and threatening people in court and all that. But,
and he wants to talk about us running away from Clubber Lang down in New Orleans. Well, nobody ran anywhere. We even went back to his work, the facing. Face on.
Ain't even worth talking about. But we're going to try to get him out today. So we're going to pull up in front of his house. We're going to honk the horn, which he's already documenting when we blow the horn. And see if we can get that clown to come out. I doubt it. But we're going to give it hell. I've packed a lunch, so we're going to eat lunch in front of his house today. And I might talk to some of the neighbors and let them know who lives in that house. And then I'm going to call the sheriff and have the sheriff come out and escort us so we are not trespassing up to his door. Hang on. It's going to be a long day. And we're headed to Miami because I owe Diane a couple of days of peace.
However, peace? We're going to bust another phony. There's no peace.
However, a little bit of work. Work shall set you free. Hey, Dan. You got a couple minutes, buddy? Mr. Bernath.
Hi, Dan. Right, why don't you come on out? It's been a long time.
Dan.
It's been a long time.
Hey. Okay, good. I'm out here right now, and so Dan's out here taking pictures and picking his nose. I hope I got that on film. Okay, good. Okay, that's great. Okay, that's great. Okay, so I'm really worked up here this morning. Okay, I'll expect her call. Thanks.
Playing right there.
And now you don't have anything to say.
If he's packing.
Nothing to say?
Here, get me in there, Dan.
And you don't have anything. We're done. You'd have nothing to say.
Hey, how about this shirt, Dan?
What a
it's a gift. Dan, no shirt, buddy.
Today.
Dan, come on, bro.
Oh, man.
I'm come bearing gifts. Videotape that right there, that white screw. That's what he's saying. People are dumping his yard. There's a white screw laying right there, it looks like. Just as long as you get that and the screws in the
there is a screw.
In the yard.
make sure I get that.
They're doing the windows, and there's screws being dropped as they load them up.
Doing the windows, having work done.
All right, let's see.
Dan finally showed up, and he was certainly at a loss for words. He never is, but he showed up carrying his heater. Like, we're a big problem out here. So I guess the media is interested.
Oh, there he is again.
Well, we just came to talk about it, Dan. Nothing to say. You invited us up here. Pulling my driveway, pulling my driveway. Nothing, Dan?
You invited us 9 times, Dan. 9 times, a personal invitation. We have them all. And so here we are. I'd love to know what you've told your wife. So Dan's wife yells that we are a bunch of creeps and perverts. I figured he had been telling your wife something like that. Every single thing you have said about me is documented. I wonder what she would think about that.
That's it.
Nothing. And off he goes like the coward he is. Yep.
The strange thing is he's worried about his wife and he's leaving her alone.
That's right. He's leaving her here to defend for herself. He won't even stand here. And since he says his wife is so terrified, there he goes. Run, Dan, run.
Waterman Broadcast.
Yep, here Hello? Comes the media.
All right, Kelly, I'm in front of Mr. Bernast's house now. He's pedaling in circles around us with a pistol on his side.
Unbelievable. This has got to be one of the strangest men that I have ever seen in my life. He has bad-mouthed me all over the internet. I've never met him. I've never talked to him. Nothing. And now that we are here, he has nothing to say. He wrote up on the internet last night that his wife was terrified of us. And what's he do? He leaves her standing right there, and he gets on his bike, and he leaves her. So either one, she's not very terrified, or number two, he don't give a shit about his life.
Oh, it's getting interesting this morning. Dan's pedaling around on his bicycle out here taking pictures, and he's armed. And So a news crew is showing up out here in just a few minutes. I think that sealed the deal when I said the guy's running around here with a pistol on his side. So his wife is so terrified that he left her alone here, and Dan just took off up the road on his bicycle pedaling around. So it's going to end here today, but we got quite a bit of video of him ignoring us and taking pictures. So we're set. Okay, that's cool because the media is showing up here soon, and you can tell your story to them. You ever Googled his name on the internet?
No.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy, are you in for a treat of who that guy is? Dan Bernath. I come all the way from Virginia because of the threats that he has done to my wife, who he has never met. Never met. And he has nothing good to say about her being so fat and her tits and everything else. Well, Crank, you can explain that to them. You invited me down here 9 times, and I'm here now. Do you got anything to say?
I'm going to say everything I'm going to say in the case Bernath versus Stevie, and no doubt I'll take your deposition and call you as a witness.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's all I'm going to say.
That's it?
That official comment.
All this? Out of the 150-some emails? With all those rants, all those insults to her, all those videos, all those doctored-up pictures, all those lies?
Threatening to kill
us. That's all you have to say? I came down here
to get away from this. I have been nothing but respectful to you, sir, all those times we talked. And then I ignored you. Disgustingly respectful to you and your services. And then I tried to ignore you, tried to go away, did everything I could, and you just kept coming back.
I'm opposed.
Over a year.
I'm opposed to ex-military becoming vigilantes like the brown shirts.
Why don't you tell the truth about
it? Like the brown shirts with the Nazi party in the 1930s.
Yeah.
And I see that happening now.
Because you are one of them.
And all that will be laid out in Bernath versus CD here in Fort Myers Court. And that's all I'm going to say.
Dan, you've never met me, though.
You're just trying to get a rise out of people.
Wait, Don's never written anything about your wife. I mean, I've never even uttered your name. We didn't come after you.
Well,
someone else did. Don has never even done it.
I'm going to repeat myself. I'm against military veterans acting like vigilantes that get veterans killed. And this is what has occurred, and this is what I oppose.
Well, why don't you do it without embellishing? Why don't you do it to somebody that did something to you?
I think the evidence will show that there is no embellishment. I think that my history of helping helpless people is right in line with me opposing the vigilantes that have killed people, such as in San Diego, where a Marine was ambushed and had his leg and his jaw broken.
Do you believe everything you read in the media, sir? You ever hear the term bar fight? You ever know that sailors sometimes get into those and that they always tell a different story? A captain, I was just minding my own business on my way back to the ship when all of a sudden,
why are you
don't
agitated?
Think that guy why might have embellished that story
why
himself?
Why are you so agitated when I'm telling you I won't say
because
anything
because I came all the way down here to talk to you.
I won't say anything
you invited
more
me down.
Then I will,
Nine times.
I will lay all this out in Bernath versus Stevie about military vigilanteism that has killed several veterans so far and got one ambushed just the other day in San Diego.
Why are you going after me? Why are you going after me, sir?
Well, you wait till that media shows up. But you attack innocent people that have nothing to do with this. Her.
I think the proper...
And that's despicable. For me to say something bad about your wife is so beneath me. Yet you will do it to her.
In court, in Bernath versus
I have tried to address it with you, sir, since you sued me the first time and made no mention of anything except what a great head of hair I have.
I have seen,
that's how off you are.
I have seen veterans kill themselves.
You have?
Because of
you have seen
bullies
them?
Who
can you
torment
give me an example?
Them to death.
Can you give me an example of that?
I will address this all in Bernath versus
a bully?
Steve.
What do you think you are? What about me?
I'm going to the airport. You're delaying me. You've already trespassed on my property after I told you. So I'm going to the airport.
So just hang out for a minute. They'll be right here. You won't want to miss this. They're just going to get my side of it.
Going to the airport on your bicycle? Ooh, that's a long haul. I can't believe it.
Okay,
I cannot believe
you,
that son of a bitch.
One guy will get you stand up.
Yeah, I'm George with NBC. Just wondering.
You work for NBC?
Well, NBC too, a local affiliate.
So you lied? You lied to me? You don't work for NBC. Is that right?
Work for the affiliate.
Well, but you didn't say that, did you?
Oh, you wouldn't put your NBC shirt on.
Come on. Come on.
No, I wouldn't be comfortable either.
If you
want
to talk,
I don't think you make them comfortable when you're walking around with that weapon. I know you took it off, but we've got it out here.
I'm walking around with a weapon, so that's
you're agitated. You're confrontational with him when he pulls up. Instead of now, you have a chance to talk, but you're not making them comfortable.
Mr. Shipley, didn't you just lie saying I have a weapon?
You're not making them comfortable. Oh, I've got the video, and I'll share it with them. But when you
did
get
you
confrontational
to,
like
okay,
that...
Okay, did you...
Well,
did you,
what right now, then,
did you want to talk to me, or did you not want to talk to
we
me?
We do. While we're out here, if you want to just maybe clear the air a little bit about what this is all about, and, you know...
I have filed a lawsuit against ex-military that are vigilantes. Mr. Shipley, I filed a criminal complaint against him in New Orleans because he assaulted Mr. Hall on Bourbon Street. He raised his fist. His wife says we've raised quite the crowd. They were inciting the riot. She yelled out to get the crowd, stolen valor here, thief from the military, things like that. Mr. Shipley and his gang have pushed six veterans to self-murder. I have a picture of Mr. Shipley with his fist. I have a picture of Mr. Robbie Robertson, a former SEAL, raising his fist, ready to hit Mr. Hall on the streets in New Orleans. And now his Gestapo brown shirt tactics have come to Fort Myers. He is raising vigilantes of ex-military. That's what this is about, and I can show you the evidence if you like.
You see his voice cracking and that eye of his twitching. Now, he's an attorney, supposed to be a litigator, but he is uncomfortable lying to you on camera. I'll show you that video that he screws around with.
I'll show you the video.
No fist was ever made. Dan doesn't mind.
Okay.
The story, you have to make it anything better.
He's also confronted a veteran in Maryland who has his fists up to protect himself, and now these Gestapo tactics. This is the second day of coming here.
Where do the authorities stand on all this in terms of, I assume you called police? Have you done anything?
I have a lawsuit. It's called Bernath versus CV. It's in U.S. District Court in Fort Myers. This is a gang of people, and they terrorize people, they wrap themselves in the flag, and then they terrorize people to self-murder. If you look on their website, you'll see that they're calling this a siege. They're saying, I have from my military service, I have a impairment. I can only urinate in a certain way, and they make fun of that.
And who told them that, Dan? You did. You pushed people to this. You incite them to say things they regret. And
I
you
think
did it
that
here,
they,
and I showed up.
I think
now you're lying to these
I think
guys
that
here.
Under our American system, we don't just show up on somebody's door, lay a siege on them, scare their wife. We don't do those sort of things.
I have
we
nine
file lawsuits.
Emails from you
we have,
telling me
we
to
file
come
a lawsuit in court. We get witnesses. We have a jury decide. He has decided these brown shirt tactics. He's entered my property against my orders. This is all intimidation. This is what he does, all in a clown face. So, I mean, his defense will be, I'm just kidding around here. They've already pushed 5 to 6 veterans to self-murder by intimidating them, and then he shows up here in very graphic fashion to show you that he's trying to terrorize me. But I'm a lawyer. I've already filed a lawsuit. We're going to court, and these Veller vigilantes will now be stopped.
My question to you, so you do have military background.
I spent 3.5 years in the Navy. I have 2 awards, Navy Commendation, Vietnam, 2 stars, Armed Forces Expeditionary Medal.
So why the allegations of Photoshop that you're stealing valor?
Well, it's preposterous. I've done nothing like that. 20, 30, 40 years after my military service, I put up a website to honor the veterans of the USS Yorktown.
They present evidence, you know, that shows otherwise. I mean, I don't know. Anyone could have done this.
Anyone could have done that, and I think that Mark Seavey of American Legion did
that one as well, just mocking us.
Here's the point. I didn't get to the point. I was honored for putting up that website that was getting millions of hits around the world to honor the veterans of the USS Yorktown. The National Association of Naval Photography then awarded me honorary chief petty officer, like 40 years after I was honorably discharged. And because of that, they decided that stolen valor, that I had gotten this award. They know that I got the award. I didn't do that. I don't know who did that, but there's several pictures of me on a homosexual's head. Not that there's anything wrong with that. That Mark Seavey did of the American Legion headquarters in Indianapolis. So if you want to look at who has expertise in Photoshop, it would be Mark Seavey, American Legion headquarters in Indianapolis. I didn't do that. I got the award. I'm going to show it to you. I'm going to show you.
Because the master chief, the officer of the Navy, is the only one that can authorize that.
That's preposterous.
He was contacted, and he said no such action happened.
What Mr. Shipley says is preposterous because
he was not claiming to be a SEAL, so I had nothing to do with him.
The Sea Scouts have nothing but chief petty officers. Yacht clubs name chief petty officers, and the NANP has named 53 or 54. The most famous that a photographer may know is Eddie Adams, the photographer who shot the famous picture of the police chief killing a man on the streets of Saigon. So what has happened here?
It's not
what has happened here is that I was awarded chief petty officer by this club, and from this they twist it, they go off the rails. And because I said these are valor vigilantes that have pushed 5 to 6 veterans to self-murder nationwide, they've now targeted me because I opposed them as an attorney rather than self-murder, as they have suggested. Why don't you just kill yourself? They said that to me several times.
You keep referring to me and my wife, Dan.
No, I will
prove
it.
Who has nothing to do with it.
Mr. Shipley, I will prove it.
Never said anything.
That it's all coordinated between you and this ain't hell, that group. I will show it's all coordinated.
My wife and I do this.
You put messages on there. They put the message on that board. That board, those poor people respond to it.
Yesterday?
The jury will decide.
You carboned everybody on your emails and they posted them.
If you are
stop
part
CCing
of this gang
everyone.
Of valor vigilantes. This is what I said. I'm an attorney. This isn't Beirut. This isn't Syria. This is the United States. When we have a dispute, we don't park in front of somebody's house day and night, terrorize them, yell at them, stop neighbors on the street,
and
like
you
Mr. Shipley
me,
has done. He has done this repeatedly, and I'll show you the pictures of how
no,
people
No, you get on the internet,
this.
And you badmouth someone's
is,
wife that you've never met, don't know anything about. That's what you do, Dan Bernath.
He posts these up on the
internet. Horrible things
that.
You've said about me.
This is
me.
What he does to my students.
We never said anything about self-murder. We've never mentioned
comments.
Your name.
He tells me to come down here, fat one.
Don't put us
come down.
And with someone
now
else.
Now he is claiming to be a Navy SEAL. I'm a Navy SEAL.
I am a Navy SEAL.
No, you're not.
Just like Bill Cosby was.
No, you're not.
Just like,
and he buys these
just like the other 53 people who have been awarded that honorary degree. Now, I can call myself that. I didn't until they started to attack me and get me to commit self-murder. Then I decided to call myself Chief Petty Officer because I rate that title, and I
Dan,
display
are you saying
it.
Now you're now, an honorary SEAL? Is
so,
that what you just said?
So
yes, that's what he said.
Yeah, I know that.
I have a picture of this
now,
woman
now
dressed as a Navy SEAL, and yet he drives around the country terrorizing people because people are saying they're SEALs when
he
they're
said
not.
That, didn't
look,
he?
Look at
yeah.
that. Okay. Look at
I'll
what
show you,
now
I'll
changed.
Show you all the pictures.
Now I am involved. Just never ends with this guy. These are all the things telling me to come down. And he does mention the stand your ground law that he is armed. Pull up in my driveway and see what happens.
This is on the internet for the last 20 years or so.
And who signed that? Master Chief of the Navy?
Here's, this is so old. This is where a chief recommended me for chief. Here's letters saying I nominate Dan Bernath. Here's another nomination. Here's another nomination. Here's another nomination from Mark Gibbertson. Here's another one. Strongly support this nomination. This is my chief in the Navy, Chief Henry. Harry. Dale Potts, my captain.
What year is this?
This is how many people will be.
But
this
you were in the, for 3 years. Somebody's going to nominate you to be a chief?
This is the website that they tore down. They tore this off the internet. They've got 2,246. It got 2,426,000 visits to honor the veterans of the USS Yorktown, and these valor terrorists tore it off the internet.
He's referring to the
referring to you.
A group. You are.
Yes. I'm part of the gang. Now here is. SEAL chief in New Orleans a couple of weeks ago. He's ready to hit a New Orleans resident in the face. here's a New Orleans tourist alarmed by this, and this is what he does. He goes from location to location, he terrorizes people, he puts it on his website, and he charges money. So this is Chief Robbie Robertson.
Does that look like a fist?
Robbie Robinson.
That is a 20-some minute video that he has scaled
here's
through
the,
to
here's
find
Here's the feared
anything.
Look on the man's face. And here's a grimace from another man.
That is a police officer. Okay.
Yeah, we don't run. You ain't gonna read about us in the book. You ain't gonna see us on the news. But we there, just like Buffalo Soda. See y'all motherfuckers down on this. Up here. Michael Hall. I'm in New Orleans all the damn check. But I seen motherfuckers like you guys. Hold up. I seen motherfuckers like you guys run. 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 Yeah. Run. Yeah. Run.
Here he is. Trespassing on my property this morning.
That's my wife's feet right there, right there.
Would you step back, please?
Yeah, sure, Dave.
Here they have called me repeatedly.
Why some more?
This Carol Shipley. They called me repeatedly as part of their harassment. This is what they did. They brag about how they have killed 5 to 6 veterans.
No, that's not
that's
me.
You, Dan.
That's you. That's not
you
us,
made
Dan.
That. Put
you
that back
it.
Up, Dan.
You did this it. They're going to tell
up.
The truth. Tell it.
This
you're
is what
tell the truth. You
this
put
is
that up.
What
that
is on
work.
This
he
is
lies,
what
Dan.
This is what is on his what website on YouTube where they criminally assaulted Mr. Hall in New Orleans. Cut that tattoo off with a effing fillet knife. This is on their website. This is how he incites them to riot.
I wrote that.
No, Dan.
Here he is, ready to hit Mr. Hall.
You see that? Does that look like a fist? And that is a police officer right there.
Here
Show
he,
him, Dan.
Here he is in Bethesda or in Maryland. He assaulted a man on the street, placed him in fear because he said he had stolen valor. This is what he does. He goes from city to city. He terrorizes people. He puts it on the video onto YouTube, and he makes money off of it. Don Shipley has monetized his service to the Navy, and he's a disgrace to my U.S. Navy.
Do you see his voice cracking and that eye twitching? You keep telling it, man.
Okay.
Nice bunch of stuff.
So I'm done.
Nice photographer's night.
You want to show him that picture that you showed of John Lea with ALS that you put his head on that?
I have no photoshopping skills. I didn't do anything.
You did that. You just said that was my picture.
Well, so there we go. Is that his wife in there? Or?
Yeah.
Oh, here he comes out. He's not done yet, so he's okay. Never done. But if you go home and you Google his name and then Google us, there's a story. He's dangerous.
Can I get your car key?
There you go. I'm going to send you the link to this video. You can see how confrontational we were.
These are for you. I didn't print out.
Did you have that one that you just showed about John Lea with ALS and the things that you said about him dying? I hope you gave it to him, Dan. That was your handiwork. I think you messed up, Dan, saying that stuff about being a SEAL and then showing that picture.
Kind of work of exposing people who are stealing ballot.
It's the amount of memorials that my wife and I attended. When 9/11 happened and SEALs started becoming so actively involved in this, we were just back-to-back memorial services, and I got tired of it. And it's no one out there is claiming to be accountants or plumbers. They're all claiming to be Navy SEALs. So we just started to verify those claims, which is simple to do, and confront them.
This is not about you, sir. Don't interrupt.
So here's a airborne person that they accused of lying about his service. He's in Florida, and he'd like to talk to you. This is somebody else they accused of stolen valor.
This is the interview that we're doing with you, not with you, Dan. It's an interview.
So we're taking his word for it over the phone that he is who he says he is. That's the best you got, Dan. Why don't you have him contact? Because every word that comes out of your mouth, from making fists to becoming being a Navy SEAL, is BS.
I was never
you
a
lie,
Navy.
Dan, to try to get people's attention.
I was never
you
a Navy.
You are a liar.
I was never.
I
Navy
don't
SEAL.
Lie.
I have it
I
on camera.
You just said
you
it
said
a little
it.
While
I've got
ago.
It recorded.
If I said it, I misspoke.
Yeah. Well, you misspoke a lot, and you incite people to do things. You and your racist, homophobic attitudes that you put up, and your hatred of women. You're a clown. So I came down here. You see your eyes blinking?
Did I?
You see the way your face is twinging?
You're a bosun's mate. You know all this about psychology and
yeah, I know enough. Yes, I absolutely do. Watching guys like you.
Is that right?
Power.
Can you give me your degree in psychology?
How about you name
I'm
a few
psychology
of these guys
major.
Yeah,
I was a bosun mate. I'm a psychology major.
Are you there?
Take his word for somebody over
okay.
the phone.
This is Dallas Wittinger. He's in Orange City. They accused him... We have word he's now going to drive up there and terrorize him.
I'm driving up to see Dallas. Me and Dallas have an air of respect amongst each other, unlike it with you.
They accused him of stolen valor as well. So did you want to talk to him?
There you go. There you go. You can search his name, too. This is the best that Dan has.
But we
so
didn't
this is
know
what
Dan.
They're doing. They're traveling.
I don't do anything. I only confront
they're
people.
They're traveling around the country, confronting people,
what difference does it make
pushing
to
them to self-murder.
I don't do anything to you. And I don't do anything to Dallas.
And then he puts it...
And then name somebody that we've done
well,
that
to. Well,
he
has a question for you.
Name
Go
somebody
ahead.
That we've done that to.
Go ahead, Dallas.
Anyone.
What's the question?
Nobody there has any purple hearts. I have two.
Dallas, have you been drinking again this morning?
Shut the hell up.
Yeah, Dallas.
Okay,
has
they
been
accused
drinking
him of stolen valor as well.
Who did?
They're
not
trying.
That. Don't say me, man. I didn't do anything to you or Dallas.
This gang
that
is trying to push him to self-murder.
What Dan does is he tries to rally other guys that have been caught for stolen valor.
I have a posting from John Lilia, his co-conspirator. Wait. That says, I have your address. I'm coming to your house. I'm kicking your ass. So this is... this
me.
Your co-conspirator, John Lilia...
I thought we were talking about you and me here.
Said, I have your address.
Up all these other guys.
I'm coming to your house. I'm kicking your ass. This is stolen valor. They've killed enough veterans. It's time that we put it to an end.
Name
and it's
one.
Going to be put to an end.
Name one.
Densmore, Dromsky... those are two Air Force veterans that you pushed
you
to self-murder.
You got any some proof of that?
Okay.
How many plumbers in New York City killed themselves last year, Dan?
We'll do an interview here. I'm going to come talk to you in just 2 minutes.
I'm not going to talk to you anymore.
Okay.
Do you want to write down his phone number?
I'll take the number.
Make
okay,
sure you Google that name.
Okay, it's 1-386-479-4843. Is that right, Dallas? What the guy from the local TV station wanted to check in with you?
Does he want to come and fly my parachute, my Navy SEAL parachute?
Oh, that's right.
See?
He has a Navy SEAL parachute.
You are in Nut Central.
So you're going to go
George.
Up? Are you going to go up there and stand in front of his house for two or three days now?
Because
he has a Navy SEAL parachute
and those phone things. You gave me
Leave
your phone
me
number.
Leave me alone
man.
Off the internet. That's why I'm here. Leave me alone. You quit writing about me on the internet. You have no right. You don't know me. I've never said a word about you. You've never even talked to me. And the things that you write about me. A 56-year-old woman that's been married to a SEAL for 37 years, and I have a son that is a SEAL that I raised. You have no right to write about me on that internet. I've never done anything. I don't want to talk to you, Dallas. Leave me alone. That's the only reason I'm here. Leave. I'm fat, but you're so fucking ugly. I can lose weight, but you're the ugliest motherfucker I've ever met in my life. You
See,
leave
you,
me alone on the
you
internet.
Can just incite
you ain't an attorney.
That.
You've lost all your credentials. Get the hell out of here, you ugly son of a bitch. That's the reason I came. Leave
right.
me alone.
All right.
Wow.
Yeah, nice.
Wow.
He came up real good and said, you fat bitch.
I did not.
Oh, you damn ugly ass
liar. I wouldn't have done that to your wife.
Fat bitch. That's what he does. He incites people.
Unfortunate incident, but I think it's a great demonstration. You're a trooper, and you know you didn't write that. All you wanted to do. The problem is, you know, Dianne's never done anything to him, and Dianne is not used to people talking to her like that. You know, that you are doing things to her like that or posting things up. She's just dedicated, you know, every bit of her to making the world a better place and taking care of people in it. When somebody says something like that, my regret is I didn't clock him, but I wasn't going to go down that road with him.
That damn near clocking.
That would have been good.
He just tells so many lies, and I've just been called a fat cunt and a fat bitch, and
every goddamn thing else all over the internet. And he had never even spoken to me. I've never written the first thing about him. Never uttered his name. And I don't know why in the hell he has decided that I'm going to be the one that's going to take his wrath. And I actually was saying to him, please leave me alone. That is why I came down here. I wanted to tell you to please leave me alone. Don't talk about me on the internet. Just leave me alone. And then he leaned into me with those fucking eyes and he went, but you're such a fat cunt. And I don't know, I think I said something like, I might be fat, but you're the ugliest motherfucker I've ever met on this planet, or something like that. He never saw me get like this. It's just, it's hard as a woman to be talked about so horribly all over the internet. You know, you can only take so fucking much. I'm ready to go to Miami.
We're going to Miami. We'll debrief some more on the ride, but we got what we came down here for and more, so I don't know what the end result is. That's what the news guys wanted, and I guess the end result is, you know, Bernath has had his way. We got our fill of it. I'm going to put a video together and show the world who Dan Bernath is, and then I think he's going to sue me again. And I don't care. You try everything. I tried every option I could think of to get this to go away, to stop, because we hadn't done anything to him. And it came to this. So I'm going to take my girl to Miami. Maybe we'll let that phony go. I think you and me need to have a drink or something. A nice meal tonight. I'm going to take my girl out to town in Miami. How about that?
Drink sounds good about right now.
Yeah.
Let's go.
This sucks. This sucks.
Let's go.
Okay.
So first stop, appetizers this morning. We've not even had breakfast yet. I thought I'd have a small pina colada, but I guess they do them big in Miami. So this is what we're starting with, and then we're going to have ceviche, and we're going to have tuna tartare, so we'll see how that goes.